Hey guys, and welcome back to another one of our fun videos. I don't even know if we have a name for it yet, but maybe like Teacher Talks or Creative Cave, I don't know.
Something. If you have any ideas, yeah, maybe. You can let us know.
Please let us know. So I'm Callie.
I'm Cassie.
And we're here to show you and guide you through another one of Cassie's cool blog posts.
Yeah, so this week our blog post is all about our favorite finds from the dollar store so that you can get ready for your class without spending too much money and that you'll pick the right things and make the most of every dollar.
Yeah. So let's get right into it. So I'll start off, and my favorite thing I'd have to say is dry erase markers. And Cassie is cha-chinging right now.
Let me turn that off.
It's fine. All right. So my favorite thing is dry erase markers because we go through these all the time as teachers. Like, I mean, I know whenever I was in the classroom, I used them all the time. The kids use them all the time. And the dollar store ones, honestly, in my opinion, are like the best ones. Just my thought. So they come in packs of four, and there's the standard colors, you know, the black, the red, the green, and the blue. And then there's also these fun colors, which I've never seen these before.
So we haven't used these yet. You're gonna get to see the very first test try.
Yes. And I don't know if you'll be able to see it from there, but possibly, because they do work well.
So our fingers are crossed.
And this is a plastic little frame that Cassie's going to talk about more, but I just want to show you.
It works really well.
It works super well.
Yeah, and there were four in a pack or three?
Yeah, four.
Four in a pack. Okay, so what you're seeing this here that she just was scratching off is one of my organization systems that I've used in the classroom that really helps you take control of what kids have turned in their work and which kids haven't. So we just bought this little plastic frame from the Dollar Tree, printed this out on a regular piece of paper, and basically it is just all of the kids' names. So when they come and turn in their paper, before they turn it in the basket, they just need to scratch off their name showing that they turned it in. So at the end of the day, you can look really quickly and see that which kids haven't turned it in.
This would also be a really good idea for like a teacher who uses something for, I don't know, it's a good attendance tracker also. I remember my partner teacher, she always had the kids sign in. And I always saw it whenever I would go into her class, but this is a great visual, like easy way to see who's here and who's not here. Like the kids just check off their name if they're here.
Yeah, and for a dollar, you can't beat it. This can also be used in, not just in this way, but in a lot of our math stations and centers, we always have a directional guide that we leave there in the station so that the kids can read the directions,
yeah,
which
that's perfect
is a good skill. Yeah, and it's just right there. It's plastic. It's not going to get broken or anything. So that was kind of one of our first finds that we really liked.
Yep. So the next one is, well, we actually have it on display. This bulletin board is not from the dollar store, but the wrapping paper and the border actually is.
And the actual bulletin board is from Facebook Marketplace for $5. So double win there.
So yeah, so this wrapping paper, Cassie found this at the dollar store, obviously, and it works perfect for bulletin boards in the classroom. Mm-hmm. Like, look how cute that is.
Even the border that you see was from the Dollar Tree. Yep. So,
I mean, pretty self-explanatory. And of course, we have our little motivational quotes that we have created, and that's also available in the shop. So it's real fun, motivating ideas. All right, next up, you've got what?
Okay, so a must-have for all teachers is a Post-it note. And Post-its can be used in so many different ways, in games, and learning, and jotting, all of that kind of stuff. So we know how important Post-it notes are to your teaching. And so included in the blog post, if you go over to CassieNowak.com and go to the blog where you will see Teacher Must-Haves Dollar Store blog. So you can read all about all of our top things.
And but the blog has like way more than this. It's got like 26 things. We're just showing you a few of our favorites.
Right? Yeah, but in order to get some freebies that we made for you, you do need to go to the blog and download them. So speaking about Post-it notes, we did create a template that you can put Post-it notes on and then print on the Post-it note straight from your printer. And so there's a couple of examples, but more importantly, there's a blank template that you can make anything that you want to have. So we have some cute, it's super easy.
Squares.
And they're designed to fit these smaller post-it notes perfectly. You just stick them on and then run it through the printer.
And the square ones too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, cool. So there's small ones and square ones. This one is a place value chart. So if you have a student with a modification or something where they get this charts and graphs to help them, then you can have them printed out and ready to go. So that is one of the freebies that you can download from the blog. Right. And one of our favorite things to do at the dollar store purchases.
Yes. All right, this bucket was only how much?
$1.
Of course. So, and we picked these up. We got the blue color, but there's other color options. So this is actually, we made it into a little trash can. Cassie stuck a sticker on there from her Silhouette Machines.
It's a bit of a big emoji.
So cute. But you can use this as a trash can. It's great for different tables, like if you have, you know, four table groups or six, whatever, you can have one in the center of each table group for trash. You can change the colors, whatever. But also, I feel like I would probably get good use out of this by using it for interactive notebooks, because we like the composition size ones and we stick them in there. And that's what we always used was the composition notebooks. And not to mention, we just finished our fourth grade, what did we do? We unbundled all of the fourth grade Teaks interactive notebooks from our Teaks kits, and we put them all into one bundle, and it's legit, I'd say.
The
whole year, you have an interactive notebook page for every Teaks.
Yeah. So. And the reason I started using individual trash cans on each table group is because I was noticing at the end of the day that my classroom was a mess. And I loved our custodian. She was so, so sweet. And I felt bad at the end of the day when I looked down on the floor and there was a ton of tiny little scraps from cutting out our interactive notebooks or other things mm-hmm. that we did. And so once I started doing a trash can on every table group, I never went back. I always had that trash can.
Yeah.
And it became a class job.
Yeah.
One of the students was in charge of mm-hmm. making sure that at the end of the day, they were emptied into the larger trash can, and it was good.
It keeps the room extra clean.
Yeah.
Custodian happy too.
Yeah. So,
all right,
what else do we have
a trifle. I think that's the last one we're going to share with you.
We do have tons of ideas on the blog, but we didn't want to talk about all of them to you. But I did want to talk to you about my favorite, my number one pick from the dollar store, and that is these trifolds. So these thick cardboard trifolds. This one I've actually already cut in half, so they're normally twice as big. And what I've used them for is privacy folders whenever we take tests. And so what I noticed is before, when I made them out of regular file folders and I laminated them and everything, they would just like flop down on the kids as they're taking their tests. And so I wanted something just more durable. And I happened to see them at the dollar store. My husband cut them apart for me, so they were perfect, not like my jaggedy edge. But I wanted to show you this because it's just an awesome idea in itself, and it is something that you will use every week in your classroom.
Awesome.
But we went one step further and made something just for you. And it is, I'll turn it around so you can kind of see. So what we've made is a math resource folder so that you can give this to your students and they can have it on their desk. And basically all of the things that we feel like are hit over and over and over again, the reference for that is here as well. So the multiplication tables, problem solving strategies, and you can even take this and kind of put what you want on there and take some of it away and put the things that are more applicable to you or the things that your class is struggling with. So this is another free download that you can get right on my blog. You just get it straight to your email.
Yeah,
that's so awesome. Anyways,
awesome.
So these are some of our favorite ones. We have a lot more that we talk about in the blog, and then we also tell you how we use them and why we think that they're really special. And for a dollar,
I know.
I mean, it's the best money that you can really spend, and that's what we try to do. Boil it down to.
Yeah, and I feel like as a teacher, you're constantly having to buy new things for your classroom because mm-hmm. kids use them so often. So yeah. Why not go to the dollar store and only spend a dollar on dry erase markers or something that you already know you're going to be using them all year long? Like, there's no point in,
yeah,
you know, spending an extra however much.
$5. Well, if you have a favorite item that you always buy each year from the dollar store, then just go ahead and let us know. Share with us.
Yeah.
We can share with other people too.
Yes.
So,
all right. Well, I guess that's it. That was fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye.